just taking our feet under our hips, and we're going to turn our toes out and then take our heels out under. So our feet are directly under our hips. And from there, we're just going to sway forwards and backwards. We're now used to getting to know our feet and finding all the surface of the foot. Just distribute your weight along the bottom of that. And then go the other way. So work in every plane. Go backwards, forwards, side to side, and round. Good. Okay, now we're going to look at the pelvis. So a lot of the core work, a lot of the balance work, everything comes from your pelvis. So I'm going to turn to the side. All I want you to do is rock, tilt your hips forwards and then back. So just move your pelvis. So try not to bend the knees. So often I see people doing this. No, just work that mobility through the hip, all the way forward, all the way back. How's that feeling? Can you feel that release in your lower back as you push forward? Were you holding tension there? A lot of people do, especially if you're working from home or you're having to sit for a long period of time. Well done. Now, all the way forward is point A, all the way back is C, and we're going to look for B. And B is going to be our neutral spine. It's halfway between the two. Keep that there. And now we're going to place one hand on our abdomen, one hand on our ribcage, it doesn't matter which one. And I just want you to focus on your breathing. So deep breath in through the nose and out of the mouth or the nose, whichever one you prefer. You can close your eyes for this and just find your breath. Now the next time you do this, feel your rib cage expanding and relaxing. And now what I want you to do from here is take a deep breath in. Brace your core and exhale. Keep that core braced. Now we're going to try and maintain that brace and breathe through it. So just take a few deep breaths holding your core in. Good. And let's start off with mobility in the neck. So just roll your neck ground forwards and back. Good. All the way down. Just tucking your chin in and feel that release. Does that feel good? Did you have any strain around the back of your neck into your upper back? Release it. Again, don't forget to breathe and keep that core in. Now we're going to change to moving it side to side. You just don't realise, do you? Just getting that mobility in the neck. And let's go all the way around. One way and then the other. Just take it at your pace. Don't rush it. And then we're just going to go. So find your balance. Forwards and backwards. So look up or just stay looking in front. So tuck your chin in. Look up or all the way up if you can. Okay, hold your neck down, hold your chin down even, and just start to roll the shoulders. Just roll the shoulders forwards. Can you feel more of that release going into the upper back as you roll the shoulders, keeping your head down? Yeah? Oh, does that feel good? Well done. If you can, take make it a little bit bigger. Lift your head up and keep rolling the shoulders. If you want to make it bigger, make it bigger. If you want to go the other way, let's go the other way. I like this song for mobility work. We're broken, but we're beautiful. We're fixing it. You want, now stay in the direction that feels good for you. Usually it's forwards for me, but today it's back. Well done, and just release that. Now we're going to start off with releasing the shoulders. So what we're going to do is raise one arm overhead and then the other. Good. Now we're going to take the hand out to a diagonal. Now you can move through and rotate. Move through your core. Again, it doesn't have to be fast. You listen to your body and go at whatever pace you want. We're going up to a diagonal. Okay, now we're going to take it in line with the chest. So next time, in line with the chest. I think this could be my kind of workout. I tell you, one thing that the lockdown has taught me is to adapt and change my workouts. I'm definitely getting more time to focus on the things that I never got a chance to focus on before. I'm loving that, especially all this mobility stuff. And then lower. And the injuries that I had post-lockdown have definitely improved. So I've got bunions on both feet. I've got hereditary knee issues. And according to a surgeon, I should not even be able to do sports that I do. But activities like this have really helped maintain the mobility and the joint suppleness that I needed to carry on. Well done. We're going to now go out to diagonal, across in front of the chest, and then lower. And I do, there's a little bit of a fighter in me that likes to prove things wrong. Obviously, safely. Let's pick it back again. Now we're going to make big circles with the right arm first. So big circle, if you can. If not, just roll the shoulder. So if you want to stay there, stay there. Otherwise, nice big circle. And then we'll change direction. Again, whichever way feels good for you. Feel like I'm swimming. If I've not heard you say it before, I'm missing my swims. Well done. I'm going to take a lat flexion out to one side and then to the other. So we're just traveling. One arm down the side of the thigh and the other one's just reaching overhead. Okay, well done. Now, we're going to take it more into the lower part of the back. All we're going to do is lead with the chest, roll the back up. So lead with the chest and roll the back up. We've done that this already this week, but we're going to progress on this today. So if you've got any back injuries, stay here. If you've got a nice healthy back, we can take it a little bit lower. And all we're going to do now is start to raise the arm. So take it down, raise the arm as we come up. So you can place your hands on your thighs as you come up, raise the arm, and then start adding that little baby back. So lean back. Good. Now we can roll down all the way if you want a little bit more. Coming up, lean back. Ooh, I'm gonna move this wire. Keep going with that. All the way down. Every breath that I've been taking since you left is like a wish on me. Well done. And then from there, we're just going to swim out, so dive in, come up, bend back, or just keep it overhead. Ah, this feels good. Well done, and release, just release it here. How's good? How's your back feeling? Okay, just roll the hips around. So remember I said like your center of gravity is that pelvic area. So if we have anything going on in that area, it can alter the way we move, the way we recover, and the secondary pressure we put on joints. So we always try to relax and release any tension around there first. So we're gonna take our feet a little bit wider. And all we're gonna do is a nice release along the inside of the leg. Well done. Good. Can you feel that? Keep going with that. Get a little bit deeper now if you want more. And more of a deeper stretch. You're in control of these. If you want to reach across, reach across. How's your upper body feeling? I tell you, I needed that after all the shoulders we just did in lift. Well done. Come back in. Just release your hips. Bring your feet back under your hips. Now we're going to find balance. Just listen to how differently, or feel how different your hips feel. All we're going to do is start off tapping out to the side on your right foot. We're going to progress this instability. Are we still breathing by bracing our core? Okay, so that's diaphragmatic breathing. We've got there, we're still holding that core in. Now we're going to tap out to the front. Now let's tap out back. Now we're going to put a little sequence together. We're going to go out to the front, out to the back. And keep that going. If you need to tap down in the middle, tap down in the middle. If you need to tap down, tap down. If you've got this, out to the front, out to the back. Keep that lengthening. Keeping that supporting knee soft. Please don't knock it out or put pressure through the joint. Well done. Now tap it down. We're going to go from that side step to an inward step. And this is great for the pelvic floor. I feel that pelvic floor working as you squeeze there. And that pelvic floor supports your whole core. You don't necessarily have to have children to have a difference in your pelvic floor. It comes with age, it comes with activity, exercise, you name it. Over 80% of men also have issues with their pelvic floor. It's just that a lot of them don't like to get address it or get help. And women, they just think it's something that happens to them. Okay, we're gonna lift the foot. It's not normal. We work to strengthen it. Well done. Well done, release. Let's just pedal through the heels. Release that leg before we bring work into it. Let's go to the other side. Tap out in front, tap out back. And if I could tell my younger self something, is to listen to my mum and make sure I do more mobility stuff like this. But I was too fast paced in life. I wanted to lift heavy, I wanted to run fast, I wanted to just be athletic. But what I didn't realise was being athletic also meant I needed to do this. Bring it up. It's taken a lot of education and a lot of slowing down for me to really bring it into my routine. And actually connecting your mind with your muscles improves your performance. Improves your technique, improves the motion in which you move. Remember to keep that knee soft. Well done. Let's tap out to the side and bring it in. Okay. You should feel that pressure going through that quad, but not the knee. Feel that stability coming from that leg, but also your core. Okay, we're gonna tap out to the side and kick it out in front. Again, if you need to tap down to the floor, tap down to the floor. Okay, feel that pelvic floor working. And I know a lot of people that will be watching this probably thinking, oh yeah, I wouldn't do exercise that didn't burn a lot of calories. And I know it. I know it. I've been there. If at any point you need to shake it out and just get back in. Well done. And let's pedal the heels again. Just pedal the heels, keeping the feet under the hips. A lot of work around the hips already. We're going to keep it there. I'm going to tell skin to come down to the floor. We're going to come down into a calf stretch. So walk your hands down into a calf stretch, and all we're going to do is pedal the heels. Keep going with that. Just keep it as long as you need to. So towards the floor, they don't need to touch the floor. Okay, and when you're ready, we're going to lower the knees to the floor. From here, push your bum back into a child. Reach your fingertips. Now we're going to lower one shoulder to the floor, so I'll turn here. We're going to bring one hand back and just lower that shoulder. So try and touch the floor with your armpit, or get your armpit as close to the floor as you can. Feel that release. Take the other arm out and switch sides. Again, armpit lowered towards the floor. And then back to the child. Just release that. And one more mobility for the back again. We're just going to come down onto all fours, lower the back, and then arch it up. Just go with that. Breathing through it. Well done. And then back into child. Slowly come up to standing. One foot, then the other. Rolling the back up for each vertebra at a time. Well done, and release it. So that was just an introduction to what I want to start building up on. We want to start working on our core, but also utilizing the full body with the core. So I hope that helped and you're feeling a bit more relaxed, not just mentally, but physically.